Last chance, guys. Kaizen holiday sale, 1 year anniversary sale, 50% off all our programs. Use code BLACKFRIDAY17 at checkout. That's 50% off. If you guys want to gain muscle, gain strength, drop fat, we have a program for you. Check it out. Description below. Tell a friend and enjoy the video.
What's up, mi familia? It's Silent Mike with another gym voiceover training session. If you're into it, if you're excited for the voiceover and you like this style of video, be sure to smash the thumbs up right now. As many of you know or do not know, I was in Los Angeles last week hanging out with the one and only Omar Issof and Bart Kwan, my homies Evan and Nadim down at Barber Brigade. We had a very big project that I have a pleasure to announce and share to you guys here. I did announce it on Instagram, but we have teamed up. Kaizen Training has teamed up with the legendary, the honorable Boris Shako, and we're bringing you guys some programs. Now, they're not available yet. Sorry for the teaser, but they should be available in a couple of weeks. So stay tuned here and on my Instagram for the announcement. When I travel, training gets a little iffy. It's not great. The week before this at Allen's, I believe I hit around 5:15, 5:05 for some triples and maybe one set of five. So for some reason, I threw on 100-pound plates because I was feeling lazy, and I hit a couple triples on this day as well as one set of five at around 5:45. You guys can second-guess my math because, honestly, I have no idea. To be honest, things felt very slow. I think we had already worked a day or two, and when we filmed these projects, one, they're very long days, and food and my hydration, although I don't make it a priority, are also on the back burner for work. We're filming for hours straight, both instructional content and hopefully some entertaining content for the YouTube. And sometimes we can go literally 4, 5, 6, 7 hours straight without taking a break or doing something, as well as sleep is off. So we're up late at night because we need an empty gym to get some of this higher content or higher quality content, more in-depth instructional content. We obviously need it quiet, so we'll literally film from midnight to 4 a.m. sometimes. So enough of my excuses. Point is that when I'm on a work trip, work takes priority. When I'm home or when I, you know, training, if I do take a training trip, which I don't know what that would mean and I haven't done it, then training would be a priority. So basically, I trained 2 days in the last 7 days. And so you guys get to see the heavy sessions. As I mentioned, that was 5:45, and I know I have pulled 7:05. But 5:45 is fairly heavy right now with, one, my strength at the moment, the amount of volume and frequency I've been training with. I don't feel that strong, as well as dealing with my back, which is not so happy. And what you'll see coming up right here is a 495-pound squat for triple. The week before this, I believe I hit 475 or 485 at Allen's. And to be honest, the 495 did feel a little bit better. My form feels pretty locked in on the squat, besides the fact that my back just gets very aggravated once I get almost anywhere above 315, 405-ish range. I feel like my breathing and bracing is good. I feel like my mobility and rehab and prehab routine is solid. I just don't think that my back can take it right now. There might be some imbalances leg to leg. There may even be some disc issues. I do not know. I will make a full update and report on my back come in the next video, so be sure to subscribe. It was fun, as always, hanging out with Bart and Omar, two guys I am very inspired by. They work very, very hard, and they're both two of the best content creators I know in their perspective areas, both fitness and comedy for Bart. To see them grow, to see them have the success they have is well-deserved. And so being around them for a week, even a couple hours for myself, I get very motivated to continue to work. So I'm excited to see what's to come. We got a couple trips coming up before I can really focus on not only the holidays, but also my training. I got a couple more seminars and things. Traveling the nation, coming to the East Coast December 2nd to come and hang out, give a little seminar at CrossFit Solace, New York. You can check that out. We'll probably be talking bench and squat and hopefully get you guys through a little workout. I think it is a smaller group this time, so we'll be able to get a little bit more one-on-one attention. Here's the one and only Omar Issof, who's actually smashing freaking weights. Both, I think he's still under 190 pounds, like 185 or something. But his squat, bench, and dead are all going up. He hit a recent PR 600-pound deadlift, which is, in my mind, just the level of strength. That means strong, that you put in some time. When someone tells me they pull 400, I say, that's cool, but, you know, there's some freaks out there that can pull 400, even 500 with absolutely terrible form. I pulled 525 pretty dang early in my career as a powerlifter. But if someone gets up to the 600-pound range, and especially with good form, I just know that's a number in my head that people have put in the hours, they've put in the time, they've had some kind of plan or program in place. And for Omar to kind of come back from over a year's worth of back injuries similar to myself, which can be mentally and physically deflating, is very impressive on my part, or on his part, from my perspective. I think he benched 365, if not 370, at sub 200-pound body weight. And then also I know he's chasing down a little bit over a 500-pound squat recently. And his form and his strength is really good. The volume he's handling in squats is well beyond what I can handle right now. I'm not sure what that weight was. Maybe 405, 415, or excuse me, 455. Omar, I think, just got up to this set of 425 or so for a triple. Not his best triple. Again, he's having similar conditions to me on this trip. Not optimal for our strength or our recovery at this time. But he still moves pretty dang good and keeps his form really solid. I think after this is my final set, there might be some benching. It didn't go as planned. I had been benching 3 times a week. And on one of those days, I would take kind of a moderate single, maybe an RPE 8 or so. And then I would do some back down sets, probably some heavier triples around 305 to 325, depending on how I was feeling on that day. And overall, bench was feeling okay, a little inconsistent. I didn't always have a lift off. One, there wouldn't be people in the gym. I do prefer a lift off. I can get a lot tighter and make my back feel a lot better. There's that 495. Hopefully you guys dig it. That's the heaviest I've been in a while. And it felt pretty good until that night. My back felt a little jacked up. Some drop sets here, the reps. I think a one set of five, about 425 or so, 435. Felt pretty good, and I like how they look. My reps all look very similar, but still aggravating my back. We'll figure it out. Don't know if it's hurt, injured, what the heck's going on, but I might have to take some rest, or I'll figure out a different route to take. On to the bench, as I mentioned, the bench footage coming up here. I think I took 345 for a single about a month ago, 365 about a week or two ago, and then right here, I don't know if, again, he put the miss in here, but I missed 375, I believe. It just felt a little heavy in my hands, and I rushed it, couldn't get it past about midway. But overall, the bench is feeling really solid. My body weight's pretty steady between 212 and 215, trying to bring that guy back down. I'll update you on that guy soon. 375, moving pretty good. For some reason, the weights and everything are moving really solid, but they are not feeling light in my hands. And I can't really explain how or why that is. Talked before in the past how my adrenal glands might just be busted from getting too fired up and stuff back in the day, and that kind of helps sometimes. I think this might be Omar's AMRAP. He had a PR 295, I believe, for 7 reps, which is an all-time PR for him. Here's that 345. Actually moves pretty dang good, if I do say so myself. But again, it felt heavy in my hands, and that's the same thing that was going on in the squat and the deadlift. I got to figure out what's going on and try to fix it. A little mini pause, shove it right back up. Pretty smooth. The miss might be coming. Here's 375 or so. First miss in probably a year. I don't know what happened. Probably just not had it that day. It's probably just a little too heavy. Happy holidays from me. I do appreciate you guys truly. Spend the week with your loved ones and friends. Appreciate them. Spread positivity. And I'll see you guys next week. I'm out.